Jason, Isabella, welcome to the película. How are you guys?
Very well.
I'm excited. I'm excited to talk to you about this movie.
The past is like a dream.
Suspect is armed and dangerous.
Images and feelings that offer some truth about how we got here. Even if details are blurred with time.
Girl has an emotional turn that really blew my mind, and I know that for you, family always comes first. How exciting and challenging was it to showcase this emotional side, one that we'd never seen before from you as an actor?
Well, it feels really beautiful that it's finally coming out. You know, I'm excited for the world to see it. I'm very proud of this film and proud of Isabella and everyone behind it. And you know, I am very happy with how it turned out because I haven't done a lot of that stuff before. I haven't had the opportunity to be able to showcase, I guess, my talents in certain ways. So that was really, I feel like for me, being able to have that was beautiful. Also being able to see Isabella transfer into this badass who I think after everyone sees this movie, she's gonna be a superhero in a second. You know what I mean? Like, it's just gonna be like, boom. I've never seen anyone fight like her. There's no way when I first met her to the moment at the end of this film that anyone saw that coming.
You got me bombs.
You got Jason's blessing to be a superhero, so that's everything.
I had a dream last night about that trip we took with Mom in the woods.
I miss her family.
My wife was supposed to start a new medication.
The company that makes the drug pulled it off the market.
Isabella and Rachel is such an intense woman and a very different character also from what we've seen you do before. I'm curious, while reading the script, can you recall that moment of what part of it made you say, I definitely want to do this?
The fact that Jason was going to be my papi was pretty much the main reason why, because he's just an awesome person. But also, I think, you know, I've never played something this kind of challenging psychologically. And as somebody who studied psychology for maybe, I think it was 2 years I studied psychology, different kinds of psychology, but it really intrigued me and it was right up my alley at the time. And it was the perfect timing.
Paying competitors to shell generic brands of drugs, that is immoral.
Our next caller is from Pittsburgh.
My wife dies.
It's your death sentence. I can help you get justice for what happened to your wife.
Who's that?
Local family gets ravaged by Big Pharma's greed. We could blow this thing wide open.
Jason, this line, parents and their children, where do we stop and they begin? That line opens and closes the movie in such a beautiful way. What can you tell us about how being a parent helped you to get into Raymond's psyche?
There's no doubt about it. When you become a parent, there's definitely places in your heart that open that you never really have before you have children. So it definitely was easier to obviously play Ray. It's the perfect moment in my career to play Ray. I think, you know, I don't like to use my children as the tool to get me where I need to be. I think Isabella was a huge factor in, I think Isabella and Adria, this is the reason why we chose them, would help me become that role. And she's just really, really, really phenomenal at acting. Both of them are. That would ease a lot off for me because it'd be very challenging to have an actress come in and not be able to like treat her like, not just treat her like my child, but just really know that they're going to be family. And Adria, we did something together before we were going to do this movie. And so we connected very deeply. And it just felt like for such a short period of time, she's going to be in it. I need someone that can make the whole audience believe that, wow, these guys have been in love for, you know, in other lifetimes, they've just been like, they're rock solid. So I think that's the trick of producing something and directing, is like really picking the right perfect people to make it easier for my job. So I don't have to, I live as a parent, but they help me, they make me better.
There's nowhere to hide. We know who you are.
People are gonna come after us, aren't they?
I need to go.
Above All, Sweet Girl is a story about grief. Dealing with it, I want to know, what did you learn about grieving after experiencing this story?
I guess I learned how to let go of certain things. You know, acting is therapeutic. And so when you apply certain parts of your life to the story to maybe make it a little bit more relatable to you, therefore, you know, a better scene entirely, you know, it is therapy. You're literally going through certain events. And when you go through events over and over again, things that you don't like to think about, it's almost like healing. It's very healing. So that's kind of something that I learned from this.
Going after powerful people was a dangerous business.
As long as we're together, we're still a family.